The best use cases of AI make you and me more productive. That's what sparked the idea for this YouTube video. Every AI tool that I mentioned today is going to help you streamline your work, generate ideas faster, and implement. Let's discuss. I'm Phil Pallen, a brand strategist. Welcome to my channel where I promise practical advice to build your brand. I spend a lot of time trying new AI tools so that you don't have to, and I'm about to round up the ones that I am really excited about right now. A few that have made a big difference in my own business. If you are not sure where to start, this video is a good idea. I'll never approach this topic of AI from the standpoint of overwhelming you. I'll break it down in actionable steps. Another good place to start is my Identify Your Target Market worksheet. 6 simple questions that help you, yes, you identify your target market for content, for business. It's free and it's my way of saying thanks for hanging out with me today. Jumping into our first tool, one that I use every single day for managing my projects, Asana, with new AI features integrated. Starting with an overview, this is what my Asana looks like. And yes, my task list is very, very, very long, but here's just a little sample of what I'm looking at day to day. For example, I'm working on this first video, so that is, of course, a task in my Asana. So I've got a due date, I've got a project. If I had other people on this project with me, I would add them. At this particular stage where I'm recording screen recordings, I do this all myself. But let's say, as I said, you know, I've got an editor, I've got thumbnail designer, I've got people working on it. That would be a separate task that I would assign whoever is working on it. So Asana is really just a great way to organize your projects. It could be client projects. In this case, we have those set as teams. It could be projects within those clients that you're working on. So in this particular case, we break things down by category within our business, both projects for me, but also things that I'm offering and serving for my clients. I also like the ability to look at insights. If I wanted, I can custom create here a dashboard, and this is going to give me all kinds of data that would be really useful as I look and see where I can improve my productivity. I also love the inbox. Mine is quite organized right now, nothing pending, but as soon as one of my team members tags me in a comment, I will get that in my inbox. Otherwise, I'm back here on my tasks. And speaking of AI, since there's an angle on that for this video, Asana just announced, it's so fresh that I haven't been able to try these yet, but they just announced some really new and exciting integrations with that interface that we know and love. So for example, it's going to be using AI to remove bottlenecks, reallocate resources, hit your goals faster. A health check, so identifying blind spots, open questions, roadblocks. Here they actually boosting productivity, self-optimizing workflows. You get the idea, a writing assistant like we see in many, many apps nowadays. That doesn't really overly excite me because as I say, these are popping up everywhere we look. Love the idea of instant summaries. Nothing overly groundbreaking here, but if this is a platform you're already using and loving and it's integrated into your workflow, I think you're going to benefit from having these AI integrations handy. If you're curious, they go into detail on their specific stance on AI. Being human-centered, you can read about that, but not in this video. I'm going to keep going to show you some more exciting stuff. The other AI tool that I absolutely depend on with Asana, and it works with Trello, ClickUp, Jira, Notion, Basecamp, and Monday, you will have spotted it there, actually, a little red timer counting, that's Everhour. It's time tracking tool. This tool itself doesn't necessarily have AI features yet, but I'm mentioning it with purpose. Let me explain. Yes, there are 2 tools in this video that I'll mention that are not specifically using AI features, but I think they complement what you're doing with AI very, very well. The first one I already indicated was this timer that is counting that you saw in the last version. That is Everhour at Work. This is a time tracking software. It is free to try it out, but I have the paid plan, which allows me to use this as a team. So you are looking at my timesheet for the week. If I click over to summary, as you can see here, it's allowing me to track my tasks, and I can now see by looking at this summary what has taken me the most time. There's no sense in you even thinking about how you can implement AI to be more productive in your business until you know where your valuable minutes are being spent, and that's why I'm such a big believer in tracking your time. Let's have a look where I've spent my time. Here I worked on a keynote presentation for a corporate client. I worked on a video course for another client. Those are things that are absolutely well worth my time, and quite frankly, I'm being paid for it. Another client project. But here, this fourth item down is something that definitely concerns me. The amount of time it took me to reply to emails from brands requesting a sponsored content partnership. That is probably not the best use of my time. And certainly 2 hours in a an entire week, that's 5, 10, 15 minutes here and there. It adds up quickly. And as a business owner, I'm looking at that and thinking, that should be better done by someone else, or better yet, could I use AI to automate that? We'll talk about that in a second with an example. But in this particular case, I would not have even been able to identify that in a quantitative way if it wasn't for Everhour. A tool like Everhour can help you identify the tasks on your plate that are taking too long or potentially aren't areas where your impact is highest, as you saw with mine. Replying to emails about sponsored content inquiries probably isn't the best use of my time, so let's delegate it, or better yet, let's automate it. I choose automation made possible by AI using our next tool. There are actually two that I'm gonna show you. The first one is Hypertype. Come across this more recently, but it's essentially, both of the tools that I'm gonna show you are one-click replies that actually draft an email reply based on the data that it has access to. So you see it here in action, it writes an email response literally almost instantly. So this is one, Hypertype. The second one is one that I've used many times, and it's called Elle. It claims to be your email assistant. Very similar. This one is a Google Chrome extension, and all you do is select the tone or whether you're interested or not interested, and you can write some additional details, and Elle is gonna help you write your draft. Here's an example. I get emails like this all the time, people wanting to collaborate with me on sponsored content. I'm generally not interested if it is a purely affiliate deal, so I provide that as extra context for Elle, and I will have it right here. And it takes just a second to actually write my reply for me, saving me lots of minutes it would take to reply manually. You saw some pretty awesome functionality there with text auto-populating in Gmail. Now let's take that one step further by eliminating repetitive typing even outside of your inbox as well. Yes, this one is called TextBlaze, and I'm really new to this platform, but I absolutely love it. It's very similar to what you just saw a second ago, where you can have text auto-populate. But this is more so to eliminate repetitive typing mistakes, as it says here. Have a look at some of the examples on the right. Let's say it's email templates. Let's say it's ChatGPT prompts. One of the things that I've noticed is that this platform is already leaning into how this can be used very efficiently and productively for AI. Think about all the times that you have written a prompt into ChatGPT and you end up rewriting it no longer, because you can actually create templates, as shown here, where you would just simply input the variables for your prompt. Very cool. I'll make sure to link to this in the description below. The kind people at TextBlaze, the kind folks at TextBlaze are not sponsoring this video, but they are offering a free month for their free plan, so I'm linking to it in the description below. If you find yourself writing text and it being repetitive, start to use this tool and you're gonna come up with lots of ways that this could be useful. Think creating SOPs, standard operating procedures, or email templates that you want your team to use. The possibilities are endless, and they have some good examples on their website. Okay, one more app. Now, what about productivity through streamlining your files and organization? Again, not an outright AI solution, but it can work in tandem with the AI apps and tools you're adding into your workflow right now. For cloud storage, I definitely recommend this next tool. As you're introducing apps and tools into your workflow, particularly those using AI, it's really important that you have things set up properly, such as file storage, especially if you're working with clients and such. There's a reason you might want to avoid popular solutions like Dropbox, Google, and even Apple. Even though they're big names, they don't necessarily have the safest options in terms of data privacy and the ability to have unlimited storage. So that's why I recommend sync.com for any small business. This tool has made the list because I personally love that they have unlimited storage, as mentioned, but they also have some really great team collaboration options that you won't find in those tools that I mentioned a moment ago. They are not sponsoring this video. I have worked with them in the past, and I use this platform myself, so I highly recommend you definitely check it out if you're in the process of reevaluating what tools and apps and platforms you use for your business. This is definitely one you want on your list. There you go. A handful of AI apps and tools that I am loving and using almost every day right now, as well as a few others that complement your AI workflow. All platforms mentioned are linked in the description below. Hopefully you found this video helpful. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like. That helps other people discover these videos, which we work hard to create for you. And subscribe for more of my videos on branding, positioning, building, and promoting your brand. Next, I'm sharing a few videos I think you'll be interested in. I'm Phil Pallen. Thanks for watching. Those coming up next.